Y brigó. I'm using my new microphone, so please do let me know if it is an improvement. Actually, I don't think I've uploaded a picture of it. It's a condenser microphone, a cheapie from Amazon, but it's certainly better than a dodgy internal microphone, so let's see how it goes. Tonight, we're going to be doing a first impressions of Erinmore Flake. No, I've not had it before, but I'm smoking it now, but up until this evening, I haven't had it. I was at the Pipe Club of London monthly meetup, and tradition is that JJ Foxes, who host the event each month, they don't charge us for it, but the tradition is that you spend a little bit of money in the shop. So I bought Erinmore Flake. The first thing which hit me was the tin note. The tin note is delicious. It's reminiscent of, for me anyway, it's reminiscent of Annadel Flake. John Green, who's the treasurer of the club, has been for many years. He didn't agree with me. He thought this was more fruity than floral, and Annadel is more of a almondy, which is true, but there's definitely more of an almond kind of essence in there, but it's still got quite a floral note to it to me, and this is quite reminiscent of it. It's a really nice dark flake, very well pressed. Just turn the light around. Yeah, really nicely pressed. Attractive looking flake. On the tobacco reviews, it says it's a Virginia Burley, and in terms of flavourings, it says floral essences, fruit, and citrus. And I guess I would agree with that. I was looking through some of the reviews as I was smoking it. I'm in the middle of my first bowl, and I thought rather than doing two or three different takes and then editing them together, I just thought I'd smoke through half the bowl, talk about it, and do it in one hit. Save a lot of time all around. I'm smoking it in my new-to-me Bentley. A very nice pipe. It's got some lovely bird's eye on it. Nice bed pipe, good balance to it. Dense as well. So I roughly rubbed it out, loaded the bowl fairly lightly. Took to the flame very well. Combustion wise, it's okay, it's not the best in the world. Have to light it every so often. I let it dry for a little bit. Now, on first light, I lit it with a match, and I don't think it was a non-sulfur match, so the flavour wasn't great to start with, but once we got through that, straight away you got this lovely fruity flavour. You're talking about apricot, plums. I can see on the reviews that people talk about pineapple. Possibly there's a little bit of a tropically kind of flavour in there. There's a whole cacophony of flavours. It's like one of those mixed fruit juices that you get with five or six different fruits together. It's that kind of idea. It's just a nice, sweet, fragrant flavour. It's it's just interesting how the flavor actually hits your palate, because it doesn't overpower. It's like, it's also not in the background, so it's kind of there, but it's not overpowering. People talk about it being quite a stout blend. I'm not really, so far I haven't really got any major nicotine hit from it. The flavouring, I'm probably about halfway down the bowl. Can't really see it, but the flavouring is still there. It's perhaps a little bit subdued compared to the first half of the bowl. This is one of these kind of blends which are, this is a classic. Ask any old time smoker and they'll know about Erin Moore, and most new time smokers as well. It's now currently made by the Scandinavian Tobacco Group. It was previously made by Murray & Sons, another well-known historic English tobacco blender. So many English tobacco companies have gone by the wayside, and the licenses have been bought over by a lot of licenses have gone over to Denmark, whether it's McBaron or Scandinavian. I'm quite surprised that I haven't tried this before. It's a very nice blend. There is a little bit of a tingle. There's no perique in it, but there is a little bit of an edge to it, I would say. You get a nice little hit of that when you retrohale through the nose. I think the flavour, as I said, is not overpowering, but you don't really get a very strong Virginia flavour coming through. It is there, but it's not very strong, and I think that the essence, the flavourings, are just slightly outweighing. When I say it doesn't overpower it, but it is slightly outweighing the tobacco flavour. But it does keep trying to go out, and it's just doing that now again. Where's my tamper? Me brain is fried. Let's try this one. I don't know where my no, there it is. You know what, with all these fancy tampers, the nails are the best. If I would compare this to Annadale, I'd say this is a more real kind of blend, if that makes any sense. Perhaps a little bit more balanced. I find the Annadale is a little bit too floral, and the flavours are a little bit too, you know, they've pushed it a little bit too far with the flavours for my particular palate. It's very nice, but I'm not sure that I'd want to smoke it the whole time. Having said that, I'm not sure I'd want to smoke this the whole time either, but it is a nice blend. And I guess, strictly speaking, you'd call this an aromatic, but you know that you're smoking a mature aromatic. This is not your typical American cherry tobacco or that kind of thing. This is predominantly a good Virginia burley blend with it's got to be a fairly natural topping, because I'm not getting any chemical at all. I'd say that in the second half of the bottle you do get more of a natural tobacco flavour coming through. First half, I would say that the, despite what I just said, that's really more true for the first half. The first half is the fruit is definitely more present. Second half, I would say that it is subdued and it's there, but not as much, and you do get more of the tobacco coming through. But I am having trouble keeping it alive. It's a very pleasant smoke. The flavours, as I say, they're nice flavours and they don't sort of get distracting. They're not too in your face, they're not chemically, they don't taste artificial. They taste like it's been flavoured with pure fruit juice. That's how it tastes. And that's a really good thing for an aromatic. Getting the burleys coming through now. Nice toasted, kind of nutty kind of flavour coming through. Very nice. So just as a first impressions, I would say that if you try to get into Virginias but you like aromatics, I would definitely give this a try. Kind of getting the best of both worlds. Although this is a Tobacco Reviews calls it a Burley Virginia, which would indicate that a Burley is the prominent component. I'm not getting I don't get on with Burleys that much, but it's really, in this particular smoke, it's a really nice blend. Nicotine-wise, the first half I would say it's mild to medium. Second half, it's definitely more present. It's a medium, perhaps a medium plus. Definitely getting a little bit heady. But it's very nice. So I would definitely recommend this. And I'll be smoking it some more. I think it's a great tobacco. I can see why it's a classic. And I'm really surprised that I hadn't tried it up to now. So Aaron Moore Flake. Give it a try. Catch you on the next one.